Hey, it's Katie Madden from balancedbreastfeeding.com. So, I've had this series of appointments lately that have all centered around this feeling of not being able to be enough in everything that you do. So, particularly with working moms, especially ones who are still in the first year of motherhood, they will say, I feel like I'm not doing anything well. I'm not being a good wife. I'm not being a good mother. I'm not being a good employee. Now, beside the fact that most of the women I work with tend to perform in general in life at about 110%, while it seems like the rest of the population thinks it's acceptable to work at 70%, which, I don't know, maybe they have it figured out and we don't, but those people like us who operate at 110% pre-kids seem to think that they're gonna go back to work and be 110%, or what they feel is enough or good enough, at work and in motherhood and in being a wife and a daughter and all of these many, many roles that we have. And the fact of the matter is, you're not. You're going to suck at everything, or at least feel like you suck at everything for a really long time, and that's okay. I'm 10 years, 11 and a half years into being a working mom, and I definitely still have days when I feel like I'm not enough of anything to anybody. But here's what I've noticed. So there's a difference between doing enough and being enough. Whether or not you're able to do enough or as much as you want to be doing in your job or as a mother or whatever, is different. Doing enough is different than being enough. And whether or not you are enough is truly something that only you can know and believe. So I'm gonna try to tell you that you are enough, that I am enough, and just keep trying to do the best you can to give enough. And I really mean enough in terms of like good enough. My good friend Melina Spiritu likes to talk about giving a prescription. She's a psychologist and she likes to talk about giving a prescription for good enough mothering. It doesn't have to be amazing. It just needs to be good enough. Get the job done, get your work done, and keep going through the motions of life. Keep feeding yourself, keep showing up to work mostly on time, keep pumping if that's what you've been doing. Keep trying your hardest to interact with your colleagues as much as possible. Whatever that means to you, just keep trying. But don't get it twisted. Not being able to give enough has nothing to do with your worth as a person, as a mother. And the last thing I'll leave you with as I send you this lovely video at the Brandywine Creek with my dog, see my dog Roscoe? Roscoe. Is that what I have found, because I often am plagued with, I'm not enough, I'm not doing enough, I'm not saving the world fast enough. What I will challenge you with is, if you feel like you can't give enough, if you feel like you can't do enough, I want you to ask yourself if you have anything left to give. And if you feel like you are scraping the bottom of the peanut butter jar and there's just nothing there, there's nothing left, then you gotta refill it. And you've heard those expressions like, you know, put your own oxygen mask on before you put it on your kid, or refill your cup, or you can't fill a cup with an empty pitcher. And all of those isms are really true. And today was one of those days where I just was feeling like I got nothing left to give. And so I went and walked the dog. And after this walk and after reflecting and being quiet with myself for a little while, I'm ready to get back on the saddle and keep trying to save the world or help mamas one at a time. And so I hope that helps. I hope that this is a little reminder to you that you are enough. And if you are feeling like you have nothing left to give, that's a pretty clear-cut sign that you need to give yourself something. All right. Have an awesome day. Bye.